Hey everybody, hey, it's time for the 100-hour review on my groundhog. A lot of people want to know how I feel about it. You know, have I broken anything, or do I need to really do much to it? But the only thing I really did to this machine, other than modifications, was, well, my very first rake. This rake is still very usable, but as you can tell, the thinner material on the lightweight rake, very easy to bend, especially if you're picking up rocks and stuff. But that being said, it's still usable, and it is the cheaper option. Since then, I bought the heavy-duty rake. Works great. Love it. Now, what really surprised me, though, I spent between $300 and $400 on this ripper. It's got half-inch thick material here down along the main beam of the ripper. And this groundhog, this little groundhog, had enough strength to freaking mangle this thing in seconds. So, don't let anybody fool you. These things do work. And if you can afford it, there's a deer. If you can afford it, buy the heavier attachments. I mean, I always consider my attachments consumables. They don't last forever. I mean, look at all the buckets and stuff on other name brand excavators. You'll see that they get reinforced and they get the cutting edges redone on them all the time. So, but if you can afford it up front, buy the heavier attachments. As far as the tracks go, the reason I really went to the steel tracks over the rubber tracks is when you're out in the woods and you snag a root or a rock, I run the rubber tracks off a few times. They're not hard to get back on, but it's kind of a pain. So I bought the steel tracks. I don't even worry about it. So, yeah, the tracks are worth it. About the only thing you have to worry about with steel tracks, not a big deal, not my opinion, is you got to make sure your pins are not working out. It's not a big deal. Just walk around your machine, tap them back in every now and then. Doesn't happen a lot. Just something you have to deal with. Like anything else mechanical in this world, you got to maintain it. So, yeah. Other than greasing it, putting, oil on it, it's not a bad machine to have, especially for the price. All right, talk to you later. Hey, everybody. Hey, we're not just out here to do a 100-hour review. I got a lot of trail maintenance to do. Every time the wind blows around here, we got trees blowing down across our trails that give us access across the property. And today I'm going to go out and clear some of the trails up, cut some firewood, and bring you along with me. All right? See you in a little bit. Thank you. Hey, if you haven't noticed, I'm going to point this out. These ATV-30s also have a bench fabricated into the bed of the trailer. Looks like I could sit on it. What do you think?
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.